Hi everyone. Welcome back to VFX Rendering. I'm excited to bring you a brand new tutorial on differential line growth. Differential line growth, or differential growth, refers to a process where lines or curves grow with varying rates, leading to complex, organic-looking shapes. This concept is inspired by natural processes like plant growth, where cells elongate at different speeds, creating curves and folds. Today, we will simulate differential line growth using the push-apart effector in Mospline in C4D. Let's get started. We'll begin with a simple circle spline, placed in the Z plane with a radius of 100 cm. Now, add the first Mospline. Set its mode to spline. And in the source spline, choose the circle we just created. Change the generation step to 5 cm. Next, create a second Mospline to record the deformation result. Again, set the mode to spline, and under the spline tab, assign the first Mospline as the source. Change the generation mode to vertex. We'll also create an empty spline, name it result spline. And place it in the definition spline section. Apply a push apart effector to the first Mospline. Set the radius to 4 cm, and remember, this value should be smaller than the step size of the Mospline for best results. Lower the strength to around 50% to control the intensity of the push. Here comes the important part. In frame 0, we select source spline as a circle. Then, at frame 1, we will select result spline. Make sure to keyframe both values on frames 0 and 1. Hit play, and you'll notice the structure begins to break apart in an organic, irregular pattern. Reduce the push apart iterations from 10 to 5 for a more controlled result. And just like that, you've created differential line growth. Right now, we see that the differential line growth is growing in all directions equally, and we need to adjust to make it more attractive. In the push apart effector, switch the deformer mode to point. The shape is still unstable, so let's head to the Fields tab. Add a random field, boost its scale to 500%, and set animation speed to 100%. Instantly, the structure becomes more dynamic and attractive. Play around with different noise types until you get a look you like. You can use a spherical field and set its blending mode to overlay for directional control. Back to the initial curve, we can change it by using other spline objects, for example flower object. A helix object. Or a text spline after connecting them. Experiment freely and let your imagination drive the form. To turn your result spline into a surface, simply use a sweep or extrude object. Both methods work great, just pick the one that fits your style. Play around and see what gives you the look you want. So So together, we've just completed the simulation of differential line growth using the push-apart effector in Mospline in Cinema 4D. Hope you found this tutorial helpful and inspiring for your next motion design project. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss out on future content. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.